Today we're diving into the world of Dask on Google Kubernetes Engine. Even if your Kubernetes runs elsewhere, don't worry, these principles will resonate there as well. Imagine this, we're going to orchestrate an installation where Helm, the Dask operator, and custom resource definitions work together to set up Dask on our Kubernetes cluster. The CRD, custom resource definition, offers an efficient and Kubernetes native way to manage our Dask clusters and their associated configurations. The actual translation of these custom resource definitions to running clusters is taken care of with that Dask operator. As the de facto package management for Kubernetes, Helm is our installation hero across this full process. Once the installations are done, your Python-based programs can do all sorts of amazing tricks with the Dask framework and parallel computing. With the concept hopefully clear, it's time to roll up our sleeves and access the Google Cloud Console. Our first mission is to spin up a Kubernetes cluster. For those of you with a brand new project, you'll need to enable the Kubernetes Engine API before setting up your cluster. Our Kubernetes cluster is pretty standard, and we're mostly sticking to the defaults. You could customize the node pool configurations to lower costs if you wish, but we'll be keeping things simple since we're only using this for a short demo. The creation is complete within a few minutes. Once done, we're going to turn on the easy mode for this setup work. Say hello to Cloud Shell, our in-browser terminal equipped with the Google Cloud CLI, Kubernetes CLI, and Helm CLI. Looking into our crystal ball, the Dask documentation, we're going to employ Helm for installing the Dask operator. Once we've welcomed the new operator in town, we'll use the CRD for Dask clusters. First things first, let's get acquainted with our new cluster, setting up the kubectl client with valid credentials. Then we'll run the Helm installation command straight from the Dask documentation. This creates and uses a Dask operator namespace, but we can still create Dask clusters anywhere we'd like in the cluster. Look at that! The install happened faster than you can say Dask. Our next move is to check how our pods are faring in the new namespace. We might not be at full speed yet, but we're definitely inching closer. For the grand finale, let's bring in a Dask cluster specification using Kubernetes YAML. It's easier with a good IDE, so let's bring the Cloud Shell IDE onto the stage. We'll whip up a directory for our cluster YAML file. We open the YAML in the editor and look to the documentation for the example configuration. You might want to tweak a few settings as per your needs, particularly if you have your sites set on a high-scale production application. However, for our trial run, this looks good to go. We paste the YAML code and eagerly apply this to our cluster. Soon, we'll bear witness to workers and schedulers springing into action, and assuming all goes according to plan, we'll be ready to rock and roll. Our workers have now spun up and there's the scheduler, so everything seems to be running successfully. Let's maybe check the logs for some of these workers to give us additional confidence. Indeed, everything looks more or less good. All right, so now that our Dask cluster is up and running, we can start to experiment. Now to do that, we're going to want to run some sort of Python workload in this cluster, which will hit the private endpoint for this Dask cluster. The internal endpoint is just for security, so keep in mind that you could modify these settings if you need to. Let's do something like a kubectl run, and we'll run a Python image here. We'll call the container Python and use the Python 3 image from Docker Hub. We'll also specify a command of sleep infinity and see if that gives us a persistent pod that we can use to run Dask code. All right, and that does seem to be okay. That pod is up and running. So we'll grab the pod name and we're going to run an interactive terminal within that pod. We're running as the root user, and we're in the home directory. Now here's where we can start to test out our cluster. Actually, we will need that Dask cluster IP or DNS name from earlier, so let's grab that. We seem to have hit a snag, as I can't seem to spot the desired service IP in our history. But let's not fret, let's exit for a quick moment and snap up the service IP again. Now, with this IP in our grasp, let's dive back in. Our plan requires the Dask and distributed modules, so let's have them installed using pip. Ready for some interactivity? Let's kickstart an interactive terminal right here. Leveraging our recent acquisition, the Dask cluster scheduler IP, we'll configure a client. Our node port service of 10.8.9.2.10 comes with the standard port 4 connection, the Dask standard 8786. Although we've got a slight version mismatch, consider it a yellow warning light, not red. Let's see if we can push forward without any hiccups. How about we cook up a few test functions to run some computations on the cluster? A squaring function and a negative function should suffice. Armed with these, we can set the stage ablaze with the client.map, then launch those parallel computations on the cluster with client.submit. Stumbled upon an error? Consider it a golden opportunity to understand debugging with our Dask logs. Let's momentarily retreat from our Python environment and delve into the logs. The scheduler often holds the critical information. A quick scroll and behold, errors lurking in the scheduler. One peak and a pickling type error catches our attention, a deserialization issue. A version reconciliation will probably give us a fix. Our current Python version on the scheduler stands at 3.10.12, but what about the Python pod? Bingo! A pretty large Python version's mismatch is probably to blame here. Our remedy? A fresh Python pod creation. To expedite the process, we'll initiate a forced termination of the last pod and follow up with a run operation specifying the precise 3.10.12 version for the pod. With the stage reset, it's time for a second attempt. Remember, our new pod demands another Dask module installation. Using the same connection IP, we see a familiar version mismatch warning, but we've closed in on a much closer synchronization of the client, scheduler, and worker versions. Let's create our two functions once again. With bated breath, we anticipate an error-free magic number output of negative 285. And we've hit bullseye. Our job was successfully dispatched to the Dask workers, and we've marked a successful setup and utilization of the Dask cluster. Should you face any struggles or have questions, please post in the comment section. Thanks for watching, and please enjoy responsibly.